And sets off sharks. He has a well-renowned climber's mane in NC.
Good matchup for him, but all the same, take it. Winning against a PR player, nothing to be nothing to be slack about.
Falco has nothing to worry about. For
oh,
sure.
Oh man.
And Steven was laughing a bit at that last stop.
Yeah,
I don't think it was happy. I don't think it was satisfied.
That forward smash just like went right over Luigi. Oh man. Okay. All right, we got the pressures.
You know what's interesting from Sam Stone is that like the variety of ways he's been utilizing forward air as like a punish, you know, a part of a punish or a bait, things like that. He's been placing them in really unique situations each time. I really like that. I don't see a lot of Luigi's lately spacing the move like that.
Could have eaten that coin and down smashed for super free, but there we see.
Oh,
like I said,
and I can't believe my eyes.
It's always something to watch for in this matchup. Falco's just like, oh, you want to up B? Okay, fine. You're still going to die.
You know, Luigi's being a little disrespectful. And
oh, no.
And BLBM has no response to any of that.
Oh, man.
Sam's going for a lot of oh, wow. Nicely placed hitboxes. He's going for a lot of walk-up actions. Not necessarily the
yeah,
Luigi,
he's
I'm going to wave dash in, typical response.
Oh, gets out of the edge guard mix-up.
And that was the fourth forward air he's used this game, and that was yet another unique situation where he baited the recovery,
oh,
yes,
that time.
But he was able to fall down and drift back from using the forward air into the back air, and that continued the stock. But, I mean, Steven did take it.
Yeah.
BLMB or BLBM?
BLMB.
BLMB.
All right. Yeah, good stuff there. Holding steady, because that was the breaking even point. So UNC manages to keep ahead, just barely.
Let's see what Charlotte has to offer. And we can actually look that
21
up.
21-20.
They're not far off at all. They have Farm, which we have already played. BLMB.
Yeah,
saw him.
So notable picks are, let's see, potentially Locke, the Ganon main. We could see. I don't know. It looks like we got
V4 Extreme. Am I wrong? This is
Wait.
This is UNC side that is picking a character. So
that's
Jazzy, yeah, for sure.
Jazzy and BLMB.
So Jeffrey Zhao. He's been known to give some of Duke's finest a bit of trouble, so I'd really love to see him play right now, see how he does. It's only one stock, so
yep, only
he should
one.
Be able to blink it away in no time.
Oh, going for that.
Wow, that was a really cool string. I'm going to steal that one day.
Yeah, that was cute.
Maybe even today.
There you go.
No, quite. Oh. All right, folks. The conversions are not really happening right now. I can't even convert my words into sentences at this point. It's so scattered. Scatterbrained.
Ooh, that was really
fatilt,
good.
Fatilt number two. Can we get three? No. Oh, wow. Incredibly placed back air. Another one. Softy.
Right,
nice.
Okay.
He auto-canceled that. Some primo stuff. Forward smash. Oh, up airs.
Ooh.
That could have been so devastating. Really lucked out there.
There it goes.
With a hitbox like down air on Falco, especially when he's just holding onto the ledge, you shouldn't be, you know, messing around with that like that.
No.
That's a really bad position to be in offstage.
Yeah, but, I mean, he got away with it.
He did.
All right, so.
And there's still smiles, so we know everything is okay.
UNC still up a stock, 20-19. Coming up.
BLMB. He did work.
Brett's switching teams here. Dude, look at all the UNC people we got.
Those shirts are incredible.
What is this mess? No, we can't support that. No, we can't, dude.
We have to support their vitality. No.
I don't care if they're the triangle. I'm just messing. I gotta give them props. They have team spirit. But they have a pretty good team too. So,
you know, Duke students are infamous for owning at least a dozen or two dozen Duke shirts of perhaps a blue, but of a variety of colors. And we could have pulled that off too, but we don't want to rub it in your face that we are who we are. We like to show you who we are.
Meanwhile, the UNCC team has given us the ham horn.
A picture can say 1,000 words, but what about a GameCube controller?
Ooh. GameCube controllers.
Think about it.
Mm-hmm. All right, so I'm trying to remember the
Fox drops
list,
a stock.
The name list.
Eventual. There we go.
Yeah, we got Jazzy versus
Jazzy versus Jazzy.
Yep. No.
All right. Ignore that information. We have on UNC Charlotte's side, it's Tiger. Tiger is that Marth player.
Looking a little ferocious, not afraid to throw out a forward smash or two.
Just going in there with this opening.
You know what?
I
really
extend
like
UNCC's lead. Yeah.
I think the way he's putting out his hitboxes is meaningful.
Man.
Whenever he presses a button, it's worth something to him. It doesn't put him in a bad position.
It's got intention behind it. So there you go. Good grab bait.
Wow, really
grab.
Good.
Oh, jab mitt, able to get out of it. Oh, unfortunate up smash.
This is such good spacing
by
both players.
Oh man,
that is what every Marth player dreams for.
Yeah, dang. Okay, Jazzy
answers
back.
Forward air to forward smash connection. Oh. Unbelievable. Nice anti-air nair. I mean, Fox can do that too.
Yeah.
Ooh. Jazzy getting a little sloppy on his punishes.
Okay. But Randall's there.
I don't think he's getting nervous. I think he's just being outplayed right now. Yeah. Nice. That was really good. Jazzy's doing
good. That's Yoshi's for you.
He was able to string together the punish into a kill. And that's what they need now. They need stocks.
He lost two stocks real quick, and he answered right back with two of his own. So really good job there, Jazzy. Definitely not frazzled at all.
A nice play.
Oh. Nice shield drop. What a
conversion.
That
was such an interesting match. They were figuring each other out so quickly, but like they didn't have enough stocks or time. Really, Melee is such a fast game to really figure each other out.
I don't remember if it was a shield drop or not, but it was a really cute up air to forward smash. He just baited him out to get up there, and he's like, "No, we take that." That was pretty
tricks,
good,
dude.
Yep.
They're brutal.
So
up air leads to so much good stuff for Marth, whether he's descending or ascending.
So coming in for UNC is Tyro, Falcon player. We're at 18 stocks to 16. I see Panda Express over there, man. That's not even funny.
It's not cool, man.
All right, but back to the match that's about to start. So Tyro's an up-and-coming Falco player at UNC.
Yeah, he's been playing for just about 2 years, but he's been a little bit on and off about it.
I mean, he's been, like, when he started out, you know, he's had things to learn, but recently, especially within the last few months, he's definitely been coming up and doing work. So,
I really like his neutral airs. That last one was a cross up. The first two were both connected, but that one, I think Tiger really thought he had that punish, but Tyro told him otherwise.
Just barely clipped him with that nair. Oh wow! No fear.
That was good. That was good. Good moves. Tyro's playing well.
Yeah, Tyro, a known proponent of the thumb sleeve.
Commentator's curse, just as we were saying that, a little bit of slop.
Ooh. Not going to get there. What the? Wow, he just trades it, or beats out that the reach out there by Tiger with that up tilt. We'll take that.
That was pretty good.
We'll take it.
I'm not going to lie. These boys are... really playing their hearts out here.
It's actually really smart because that forward air hit in a place of the down air that you might have thought he was going for wouldn't. So if he meant to do it, props to him for knowing that that would work. If he didn't, we take those.
So it was weird. Like, Mart's body was, like, turning around in the air vertically. And, like, the hitbox just happened to be... The hitbox is a little bit bigger, I believe, than their back air, which is one of their best moves. Not that it's any better, because it doesn't stay out as long, it doesn't have as much combo potential or kill potential, but in that situation, dude, he didn't expect it.
Has a lot of... the move has a very long duration, too, so, like... Even though that first hit is really good, you commit to an awful lot when you try and use it. So, situational. I mean, that was actually really cool because he hit like underneath, like right here. So it was a really interesting hit. Like I said, if he meant to do it,
it was really good hitbox placement. It had to happen because if he nared,
I mean, he could have gone for like down air.
It's possible.
Regardless, it was cute.
Yeah, he did good.
Yeah. All right, guys. It's who's looking like we got V4 Extreme coming up. I didn't see how many stocks he finished with. I think it was 3.
Yeah, it was 3.
Which means he only lost one. This is super close, guys. This is one stock apart. We got 15 to 16.
There's still plenty of more melee to be played, which is nice. A lot of these crew battles felt like they were a little bit short-lived.
We got a Falco Ditto going on here.
This is not a Ness, is it? No, Falco Ditto.
Yeah, we got Blue Falco and regular Falco? Huh.
Yeah.
V4
Yoshi's
switches.
is the primo stage for Falco Dittos.
Yes. Yeah, no, I agree with you.
Well, if you play anywhere else, you're not getting the combos you would have dreamed of.
Oh. We didn't even get a chance to start.
We got some disrespectful banter from the crowd.
Alex, yeah, we take this.
Not giving these players the respect they deserve as people and humans and smashers alike.
All right, so Tyler going.
Okay, I think we'll be able to.
We're gonna start this time. Match. Oh, he gets shot in the face. Jumping the gun there. For realsies. Ooh. Okay. And that's a shine. Oh, he didn't quite get the down air that I thought he was going to connect with.
All right, for you viewers at home watching, this is the way these Falcos are playing are the, I want to do this, so I'm only going to do this, and I'm going to find the shortest way to get my combo off so you can die. And they're both playing very...
I mean, that's
the word. That's the word.
Put him off stage and kill him. Oh, he didn't see that coming. Okay. Okay, ooh. Alex, I see you.
You know what?
Good job, V4.
That was pretty awesome. Yeah, V4 Extreme was like, you know what? Since we're both being gritty, let me just turn around and up tilt you for your trouble.
I'll just take it. Oh, okay. So
he crouch cancels.
It, sells it with a jab. Good damage there. Oh, not quite far enough to wave dash out. Ooh.
All right, we have rap battles. We have put in pops. We have Bill Cosby in the crowd. Shout outs to Bill Cosby.
Got that up tilt, back air, and then
you know
yes.
what? That worked out. That could have been a shine up B Firefox, which might not have worked, but it would have been way cooler.
Oh, he doesn't quite. Okay. We got.
Nice.
I like the way he's able to keep the pressure on there. He didn't drop that.
These players are exhibiting very similar types of tech skill. They seem to be going for the same stuff on each other.
Yeah.
The forward smashes are much less common.
Oh, what?
Oh wow! They're traveling the world.
He's like, I'll take it.
Catches. Is there going to be a down air in the future?
Catches him reaching. Yep. Down smash.
There had to be a Falco on a platform.
Oh,
expects
good
nothing less.
Wow, that was really smart.
Oh.
Could have just walked over and forward tilted.
Forward smash.
That angle.
Easy money.
Nice tech.
Should have suicided. Oh, didn't matter.
He says we take this. Okay.
I think it might be over. I think it might just be over right now. Something tells me.
I don't know about that double jump there, but.
Oh, no. Tyro can turn it around right now. before Extreme is not pressing buttons.
Yeah, he's... Okay.
Oh.
Play. He is sort of playing scared, and then he's like, "Oh wait, no, I can just do this."
Oh wait, there's a C stick that does all the hard work for me.
I see that opening, and I got you.
Shoutouts to Falco. Shoutouts to 2001. Shoutouts to 100 Man Multi Man Melee. Shoutouts to Sakurai. Shoutouts to Sheik supposedly being the best character in the game, but it turns out they messed up, and Falco was the best. But then it turns out they messed up even more, and the metagame developed, and then it was fine.
Yep. Yo, we got Wei Lin in here now.
I haven't seen Wei Lin play in a minute. I know he has some drones about light shielding, but I think this setup is perfect for him.
Where's Wei Lin going?
I don't know if he realizes the consequences of his actions.
I don't think he does.
He has no emotion. Okay, now he's smiling. He knew.
Yeah.
He knew about that.
Dang. Did you expect to see that?
Is this what you wanted from Duke Smash's second tournament ever?
This is a pretty nice venue. We are on the we are dominating the entire second floor of an open air atrium in the is this the engineering building?
This is.
It's pretty nice. There's like a giant staircase through the middle. And we're sitting playing up next to like a bunch of railings and stuff, overlooking the ground floor.
Innovative design, I think, is something that Duke is really, really prideful.
Oh my God, I hate to see that.
Did he just stand by the ledge and down smash?
Oh my! Oh, okay. No.
Oh,
ooh.
You know,
good job on Wei Lin.
Wei Lin is really closing out these few stocks. If there was a gap, it's slowly, actually, very quickly tightening up.
Yeah. Yeah, because UNCC is ahead right now.
I don't know if you saw that there, but V4 Extreme did double lasers from the ledge, and he up smashed. This is reminiscent of DeShizWiz versus M2K. Game 4 on Yoshi's Story.
Yeah.
Shoutouts to DeShizWiz.
Yeah, we take those.
Wherever you are in the world.
Yeah, he might be in the Ratchet, I think.
He could be. Oh, wait, he actually is.
Oh, wow. And just like that, he takes both stocks real quick. Good job to Wei Lin right there.
Wei Lin doing it big, as you would expect. But Peach's dash attack is closed out the game, and Peach's dash attack is one of the wackest moves in
I think this was a bait to put. Do you think
GameScoop Scrub is meant to be here?
Yeah, I think so.
Do you think he can slay Wei Lin?
It's definitely possible. I know he's pretty comfortable in this matchup.
I like what GCS does with comboing floaties. I mean, his up airs aren't.
I mean, we saw where he was with that in the Duke match. He was perfectly fine with.
You know the way he was playing it wasn't a 20 GX. I'm gonna do this all perfectly. Oh. And I'm only looking back if I'm looking at her booty. At her booty.
Dang. Okay.
And those are the follow-ups we want from GameCube Scrub. We don't want him to get scrubbed out by Peach's shoddy punish game. There are holes, and up air is the way out of it.
Ooh. Yeah, he definitely needs to answer that back real quick. Oh, doesn't get the dash jump. Oh, wow, the weight was real there. Man.
How many more times can he get nared before he dies? Oh.
I guess the answer is zero.
Wei Lin is a truck right now.
Ooh, getting caught in that blender right
there. There is no stopping this man.
Woo.
Oh, my. No way.
What is he doing? Oh.
Is there going to be a slap in the future? No. No, no, no. Jeez. Not the greatest DI, and that should be an easy edge guard.
Oh.
And it is.
All right. Well, he got one.
All right. I think he did a little bit of soul searching, but I think that's super guaranteed. So we'll see what he can do at this low percent, but he's not able to really stop Wei Lin.
Ooh.
Again, Peach's moves are... Oh, my God.
Oh, he got out of it that time.
With the flow cancel, it's just so safe. And the dash attack has huge priority. Not that it's real... Oh, free.
Well, we'll take it. All right.
It's not at all unfair.
Making it respectable.
Yeah. Dash dancing. Dash dancing got him that neutral. Oh, ooh. Slaps. This is probably it. Just like normal throw. Oh. Should have covered everything.
Oh.
Yeah, nice. Wow.
Yeah, that'll do it. Wow. So, like I was saying, I think that was a bait. Put Wei Lin in. And
what's the stock count looking like now?
It's 8.
They're
to,
down a solid 4,
10.
Right?
8 to 10, I think. It might be.
Oh no. Wei Lin lost 1 stock.
Oh yeah.
No, 2 stocks. He had a JV 2.
It was
JV 3. Sorry. I am
it was
so
tied,
not accurate
and I
want to right
say
now.
It was 12. But
I mean, Waylon has 2 stocks and Sprankles has 4. That
I think it's 8 to 12.
Let's see. They have Jay Willy and Nanos left. So that means there's 10 stocks on UNC side. On the other side, we have Lock Robster.
Okay.
So that means it's 8 to 10. Yeah, I think that's right.
Interesting. Yeah, that's a tight situation right there. When you're down to your best player and and Lock against probably arguably the one of the best players here, then
hold on just a moment. is this matchup really this bad?
It really depends on who you ask. I really think that Hungrybox is like super super comfortable with it. So,
but Wei Lin is not showing us like a dominant sort of playstyle to this.
Yeah, he's definitely not showing not being afraid of this at all.
I mean, Peach has to have turnips. Without turnips, she can't outspace a Jigglypuff.
Yeah,
it's just not possible. Jigglypuff outmaneuvers her and outprioritizes her.
Yep,
that's everything. That's everything Peach wants to be doing to you.
Wow. And then that up smash. Yeah, so that's...
It wasn't really like a perfect down air conversion. It didn't completely combo, but he knew that Wei Lin would jump at that moment, and so... Or wave dash, whatever it may be.
Yeah.
So we got that punish really, really, like, on point. It's good.
Oh, he could have... He almost had that. Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, Wei Lin is teching these, but
yeah, wait. I mean,
Puff can just stay around and
given
put on the pain.
Given the matchup spread, Wei Lin is definitely making a name for himself in terms of like this physical match. He says, "I'm okay with this. We got this."
This is kind of such
afraid.
A tough position.
I'm not afraid of Sprankles, he says. Oh.
How can he not be, though?
Okay.
I like the movement.
Ooh, wow. What a clutch forward air.
It's so hard to kill Puff as Peach.
Oh, we got the forward throws, though. That's one thing that'll do it.
In a matchup where you can't outmaneuver the other player, it's so hard to get them to mess up their DI.
Now he takes it. He got it.
Neutral air is a really good kill move, but can Wei Lin get Sprankles up to 100 again? That's over.
That's going to be it. I was going to say,
it was a risk, but
Sprankles really needed to stop letting Wei Lin pull turnips. And that was, that's actually why he lost as many stocks as he did.
Okay, so
Waylon was able to pick up the turns, but the way Sprankles was positioned, he wasn't doing the same thing, like tracking Waylon down to his spot and getting down close to ground level, mm-hmm. where Peach can jump up and start floating and establishing that pressure.
Yeah,
and
control
use
of the
platforms
air.
Also. He was kind of staying in the air and then waiting for his moment to come down. He was getting to stage. He was getting stage back pretty much for free. If it was top platform or center stage, whatever it may be.
Yeah, definitely a good job. So we got Nanos coming in.
Nanos. And that was they traded two stocks for two, right?
Yep. But that keeps UNC is still up two stocks. Nanos with the shout out. Rocking the free tag. Actually West Balls.
Sprankles going into his rollout mode.
We're taking that. Sticky walking. I like it. So we got Sprankles, and then with Locke waiting, and then who's left after this? We got Nanos here, and then who's the last player? Oh, Jay Willie. Ooh.
And on the other side,
it's not looking good for UNCC.
Yeah, we have Locke as the others.
It's really kind of going to be up to Sprankles here.
Well, it was good on Sprankles. There was a free rest opportunity, but since their team is so down,
you can't be doing that. You can't be playing like that.
Maybe if he's able to take Nanos' stocks pretty cleanly, he could start doing that
later. Trading stocks is not a good idea in a crew battle.
There's only one way he can recover, and there is no punish.
I mean, yeah, he maybe could have gone out there and been disruptive, but
I mean, there is maybe one other option for Sprankles to pound away from the stage one extra time, but like in reality, Falcon, if he's on stage, he can react to that.
There you go. Yeah, picks it up pretty clean. Wow.
Oh, almost died.
It's a really good.
Wow, yeah, nice. Both of those were not the worst DI, but they weren't the best DI also. It's kind of interesting how Nanos
really,
is
I'm actually
getting
kind of
openings.
Surprised that he lived here on Yoshi's.
Ooh, yo, this is so sad. I can't believe that knee missed earlier.
Oh, wow. Good landing there. Oh,
that poke.
Oh, picks
nice.
It up.
And he's capitalizing too. It's great.
Nice. Wow, good job there.
Good conversion.
Dude, Emerson's like, no.
There was nothing more confident
than that.
The
Raw is freaking down
that
here.
Was
oh my gosh.
Goodness, Nanos. My goodness.
There was like nothing he could do about it either.
Well, it's cool that the momentum's a little bit back on his side now. He's getting that percent lead. I mean, if he gets a tax on maybe another 25%, he can get a...
Yeah.
Oh, wow. He's almost there, too.
Oh.
He essentially now has free follow-ups from down
throw. If he gets
this
stock, it's pretty much over.
He has to get that grab now, though. If he waits too long, it'll...
Oh,
wow. Oh,
my goodness.
It didn't even matter.
Yeah. All right.
UNC Charlotte is for sure on their last limb. They need to really do work with this stock.
Locke has his work cut out for him. He's got four stocks to take six against a Falcon.
And
As Ganondorf, he's got two Falcon stocks and then Jay Willie.
That is
an extremely tall order.
At what percent can Sheik chain grab a Ganondorf?
To like 85.
From zero?
Yep.
Jeez, so... Locke's really looking at a long road ahead if he's to take this match and the next.
Yes, indeed.
He was doing pretty well against Duke in that crew battle for UNC Charlotte against Duke. So let's see if he can pull off something similar.
Yeah. Oh, we're going back to Yoshi's. It's a smart choice. Black has definitely leveled up a lot in the last, like, 3 months, though, so...
Locke was doing some really cool stuff. He was reading wave dashing in with down air, and
yeah.
they were like the way he plays his neutral. You don't really like expect that to happen as a viewer. I don't know about as a player because that's a whole different story. But I don't expect them half the time.
Ooh, oh. He just takes it. Okay.
Yeah, that was so risky, Nanos.
Wow.
So Locke risky, bro.
Yo, so are we about to see a 4v4 Ganon Sheik to take it all? Oh, never mind.
It was good DI. He just held
it. Really good DI, actually. Wow, the roll.
I mean, he could have DI'd a little better, so we had more recovery options. But it's okay. It's still trading stocks.
I spoke a little bit too soon there. Oh, he went for it.
They're both, one person's on the top using their down move, the other person's on the bottom using their up move.
Ooh.
Nothing like some good old-fashioned 2001 melee.
I mean, this is a Ganon who is comfortable with his matchups. Because, oh my god.
No fear dash attack.
Wow, that auto-canceled. Oh, that's him.
He was so
greedy.
That's
it, that's it.
Why did he want to knee that?
Wow. All right, so 3-4, Sheik against Ganondorf.
He still played pretty well.
This is for everything right here.
So, really good stuff. Let's see if Jay Willie with his Triforce, rocking that Triforce on the back. He can do that. I'm really interested to see. I don't think Jay Willie is the type of chain grabber that.
I don't know, man. It's melee games.
You're right. But I do expect to see forward tilt combos and a lot of
all
them.
All day.
I think that Jay Willie will opt for those more and see, kind of like work with the DIs that the Ganondorf reacts to them with.
Yep.
Then manipulate him from there. Because
you
have Needle.
You have Needles. You have so much. You have mobility. All he's got to do is just maintain stage presence. He threatens with that grab. Clean movement. Wow, and it's just that easy. Oh, wow, Jay Willie's just ready
nice.
For everything.
Nice up tilt. Both hits and up smash, sick. And man, Locke hasn't even gotten an opportunity.
He hasn't really gotten a chance to play.
This matchup is so rough.
Although, his recovery mix-ups. Oh, there we go. Jay Willie called it.
One more. But curtains.
The weak back air, doesn't matter. Yeah, this is such a rough matchup. Ooh. But we got reverse chain grabs. So.
Oh. Ooh. Sick. That almost connected, would have been so good. And I mean, he's really fortunate to not be dead right now, after that flop.
Wow, that wave land, dude! Did you see that?
Yeah, it was crispy, dude. That was a bizarro flame level.
Yeah, it was.
It should be an edge guard.
Ooh. Oh.
There's a lot of pressure on Locke right now. Jay Willie must be feeling so comfortable right now. Yeah, and that will be it. Needles. That's it. It's done.
Well, Nair scoops it back up. Needles for the... Oh, gets the jump anyway.
I would have liked to see him do the reverse forward air.
Yep. He says, I didn't need it. You weren't going to make it back anyway.
The stuff that P. Diddy would be proud of. Oh. Jay Willie has no mercy for Locke right now. There's no sympathy here. Come on, Jay Willie, you can chain grab your own self. Why would you chain grab him?
Ooh, we'll take it. All right, he got one.
I mean, at this point, who would not be content to trade? This is so devastating.
There's
nothing
there.
Left for them, man. UNC took it. It was a tight battle. For a 7-person crew battle, they kept it so close. The whole time.
Well,
really exciting.